my beautiful little baby loves. It is me, Loey, mom, dad. I actually really prefer being called dad over being called mom, and it's not because like mom makes me feel old, it's because dad makes me feel cool. How are you guys today? I decided to film this makeup look really last minute for Valentine's Day. And I asked on Twitter if you guys even wanted to see it, and most of you said yes, and then I asked if you wanted to see a tutorial or a really long, actually to be specific, a 69 minute get ready with me, which I know this is not 69 minutes because that's ridiculous, but you get the joke. Everyone said get ready with me, so this is gonna be a really chatty, kind of in-depth video. I wanted to film kind of my like go-to no BS smoky eye. This is something where I know it's gonna look good and I can modify it any way that I want, but this is what I do when I'm just like, all right, I gotta look good. I gotta look, you know, like a fancy lady for a fancy party or to sit in my house and film videos in my yoga pants all night. Tomorrow I have like a really creepy Valentine's Day themed story time going up, so I wanted to put up my makeup video today. So yeah, I hope you guys like it, and if you want to know how I did this to my face, then just stay tuned. I have a new lens on this camera and it doesn't zoom, but supposedly the autofocus is a lot better. Just to save a little bit of time, I went ahead and concealed my eyelids just using my Maybelline concealer that I use on my eyes pretty much every time I do my makeup. And I also did top that off with a little bit of eye primer. I like to use an eye primer just so things do not crease. Now I'm going to take a bit of Airspun loose translucent powder just on this Tarte brush. I'm going to go on top of my eyelids just super quickly. Then I'm going to like super load up this brush and I'm going to go under my eyes. I'm really gonna pack some product here at the outer corner because this is gonna allow us to get that really sharp cat eye edge without massive amounts of cleanup. Also, just get it in your hair because that really add to the overall effect. You could use tape for that like hardcore super sharp edge. You could clean up with makeup wipes. It's really up to you. I like my line to be a little bit softer, so I just like a more casual application of translucent powder. Now I'm gonna go into the Kylie Cosmetics bronze palette. Lately I've just been using this for every look, every tutorial, so I'm gonna take this matte brown up here, kind of just everywhere in all honesty. This is such a messy application of eyeshadow that some of you are probably gonna be horrified, but I just like this color to go absolutely everywhere. I mean, I blend it all over the lid, I blend it into the crease, I kind of take it up onto the brow bone. I try not to go too far past that translucent powder line, but if it does, it's okay because we can clean it. This part of the look takes minimal skill. So like if you want to convince your 4-year-old niece or nephew that they should be a makeup artist when they grow up, you know, just let them do this and they'll spend the rest of their lives just thinking they have a natural gift, you know? I'm gonna use this Makeup Geek Soft Gnome Brush. Also, can we just take a moment for how every one of my brushes, everything I own for that matter, is just coated in translucent powder. You can go a couple of different routes with this. For something warmer, you can always take like a more ruddy brown. For something deeper, you could go straight into this like espresso color. I typically like to use 3 darker colors in my smoky eyes, so I'm just going to go into this slightly deeper brown for now, and I'm going to kind of messily again bring this into the outer V, and I would say bring this halfway onto my eyelid. After every color added in this particular look, we're gonna spend some time in blend. And this is because you just want this to be really seamless. The more blending, the more better. My mother is an English teacher and she's probably cringing watching this. Hi, mommy. I feel like we're hanging out and doing our makeup together, so I have to apologize for constantly looking down at my phone, but then I remember I'm just gonna edit that out. My husband and all my friends are out in the middle of the desert right now because army problems. I'm gonna take the espresso brown, this time on a Makeup Geek pointed crease brush. You will see a lot in this tutorial. I really like my Makeup Geek eye brushes. I like all the brushes. Their eye brushes are just really, really special though. I'm gonna get right up into that outer V. Really focus that on the outer corner. Blend it into the crease. The trick with smoky eyes is always going to be starting out with less and adding more, because you can't blend away, you know, too much darkness. You can't really ever make that look seamless and perfect again, but you can always add more in. And I think that this is obviously where you can really start to see the shape of the eye and it's not just like a muddy brown mess. I'm just gonna get this look to you guys a lot sooner, but I had zero motivation And no Valentine's Day plans because every year on Valentine's Day, my man is coincidentally somewhere weird in the world because of the military. I don't know what it is. We've literally had one Valentine's Day together since we got married. It's actually a running joke that it's like a conspiracy theory because all of my friends are the same way. They're always like, yeah, like my husband, my boyfriend, whatever, is never around on Valentine's. Now I'm gonna go into this nice dark matte black on the same brush actually. Oh, I did spend a second and just, of course, like I said, I don't want half of this video to just be blending, so I'm doing it off camera, but you will just want to blend with that OG fluffy brush after every step, like I said. So just kind of blended it out a little bit. Now I'm taking that matte black. You can see for these more like precise steps, I'm like getting up and close to my eye with one of these brushes. Also, yes, I know there's eyeshadow all over my face. The translucent powder will pick it up. This is gonna go into the very, very outermost corner here. Spend 30 years tapping off the excess. But you don't end up with black eyeshadow absolutely freaking everywhere. I do this technique a lot. Actually, really recently for a few videos, I was wearing basically what you're seeing here, but all over the eye. So I packed black all over my eyelid. And it's a nice effect. I just think it can be really harsh when it's all black all over the lid, and I have to be in a specific mood for that. I have to be dressed in a certain way for that, you know what I mean? Whereas this, I really think is super wearable. Yeah, it's still black, yeah, it's still dark, but it's actually super flattering on the eye. And in my opinion, really, really, I don't know, just like flirty and fun. And I feel like absolutely anyone can do it, you know? There's not any fuss or anything with it. That's why it's like my no bull crap smoky eye. So of course we're gonna blend, and just for funsies, I'll only blend out this eye just so you guys can see the difference here. As long as I'm blending, by the way, I'm going to be addressing this in an upcoming video. I did chip one of my teeth. It's not my actual tooth that was chipped. It was the bonding on said tooth. And I got it fixed. It immediately broke again. I'm just looking for a better dentist right now. So, in case you're wondering, that's what happened. Look at how, like, blown out and soft and, like, hazy this eye is, of course, compared to the unblended eye. It's just a matter of blending 99% of the time, you know? So to get a nice sharp edge, you're just gonna wanna dampen a Q-tip. You could use water, you could use makeup remover, eye cream, your own saliva, I ain't judging. And literally just run that right along the edge like I showed you there, and then take the dry side just to kinda like buff and blend that back out. For the inner portion of the eye, this is so weird and so like high maintenance, I guess I just always feel like whenever I put powder down there, like when I do my concealer, it kind of bounces up and over and it just ruins everything. So I'm just gonna wait. I'm gonna go ahead and prime off my face. Today I'm using the Makeup Forever Hydrating Primer. And I actually really have been liking this lately. I'm gonna be using the Kat Von D Tattoo Locket Foundation just for a really full coverage look. I'm gonna be taking two pumps of Light 44 mixed with one pump of Light 48 because I'm kind of somewhere in the neutral. In the middle area. Kind of mix it up on the back of my hand, and then I'm just going to dot it on the face and get it all in my eyebrow. What is it with me and getting products in my hair? I'm using my massive Tarte foundation brush, and I'm just going to buff this into the skin. Not even sure if this is gonna be noticeable, but I don't know if you guys can see this. I'm having like some sort of reaction to something. I kind of think it's a perfume or something. I don't know. This foundation is so full coverage. I've been using the Remarkable foundation a lot lately. And don't get me wrong, that one's full coverage too. But I still feel like I can kind of see like my skin through it. You know what I mean? Like Kat Von D Locket. Like I might as well be wearing a mask that slightly resembles my own face. And sometimes, like especially when I do heavier looks like this, I like to look really flawless and, you know, it does wind up looking more natural with product sitting on top of it, but in the initial application process, it's a little bit crazy. For concealer today, I'm gonna be using that Maybelline Age Rewind Brightener shade. And I kind of have to be careful with placement just so that it doesn't disrupt that hardcore eyeshadow we were working so hard on. And then I'm gonna top it off using my Rimmel Match Perfection. I just stick to the same concealer all of the time. I know that it works. It never really crepes up under the eyes. Just lasts for so long, highlights beautifully. This shade is just perfect for what I need. I recently got the Tarte Shape Tape because everyone and their mother raves. And I don't even want to try that, even though like I know everyone loves the product because I just know this works for me so well. So just highlighting everywhere. This is also a really thin concealer in case you're like, dang girl, you're using a lot. Then you're just gonna blend all of it in. To set the under eye area, I am gonna be taking a little bit of Airspun, just using that same Real Techniques sponge. Yes, it's damp. You guys have no idea until you try it. Cause I used to think when I saw people do this, it was so weird. Like, why would you apply powder with a damp sponge? But it just melds it into your skin so beautifully. And when you like wind up brushing away the excess, it just looks so good. This is also your chance, by the way, to really carve out that outer edge of your eyeshadow. Make it as sharp or as hazy as you want it. Caffeine break because you're filming at 11 o'clock at night. I always have such good intentions on filming days. I'm like, yeah, I'm gonna be so productive today. I'm gonna get this video edited, uploaded, like ready to go by 3 p.m., you know, because I wanna upload this tomorrow. 11 o'clock at night, I haven't got my work done. Setting off the rest of the face using Rimmel Stay Match. Is it weird that I use a different brush to set above my upper lip than I do? Like, I always use a giant kabuki for the rest of my face, but on my upper lip, I just use a tiny brush, and there's really like no reason for it. I just feel like taking a kabuki right there, it's like awkward. Maybe that's really strange. I don't know, I've never actually thought about that before. Before I move any further with the rest of my face, I'm just gonna polish off those eyes, in terms of eyeshadow, anyways. I know my makeup routine makes zero sense. That's why I don't do videos very often, because I feel like it must be very frustrating for it to be like, I'm gonna do foundation, now I'm gonna go back to eyes, now I'm gonna contour, now I'm gonna do my brows. Like, nothing makes any sense in this routine. And that's okay. This is where you can really do whatever the heck you want. You can do glitter in the inner corner. You can do a matte color like this one in the Kylie palette right here. I love this because it really winds up like opening up the eye so much, and I like a full matte eye. You could also use something like this really pretty shimmery pink. Today I am gonna use that matte color just because I really want that like eye opening effect, and you can see I'm like hella packing it on just right there. And then I'm basically gonna clean off all of the product on my little flat shader brush, and I'm gonna blend. I don't wanna like get this color absolutely everywhere by any means. While we're at it, I will also take that matte color and go right under the brow bone with it. Almost kind of, sort of baking. Sometimes I bring up my shadows too far on the inner part of my brow, so that's why I'm like hardcore putting down some shadow there. Just gonna take that blending brush that I use for pretty much all my blending, because it has like what I would consider to be a pretty healthy mix of all of the three darker colors that I used on it. And I'm just going to blend one last time up here. I feel like I prefer things top heavy more than a lot of people do. Like, what a lot of people consider top heavy, I'm like, yes, I love how this like opens up my eyes. However, this is a little bit extreme even for me. So I'm gonna start off with the brown color that I used in the crease initially. I just hit pan! What a special moment. This Kylie bronze palette, I'm telling you, has been getting so much use for me. I'm going to be using a Makeup Geek Outer V brush, bringing that onto the lower lash line. I'm gonna smoke it out quite a lot, not worrying too much about that fallout because I still have quite a lot of translucent powder under there that I can just brush this away with. And can you see the difference here? Like that really natural mid-tone brown that we used even makes, it just balances things out so nicely. And sorry for the mirror like 2 centimeters away from my face. I can't do the lower lash line without something really close to the face. I just can't. My eyes start watering. It's like I don't trust myself when the mirror is too far away, if that makes any sense. I'm not gonna take all of the steps in terms of like the dark brown and all of that on the lower lash line. Instead, I'm going to take the most minuscule amount of that black. I mean, I'm just barely tapping my brush in there. I'm gonna tap off most of the excess. I'm going to place this into the outer corner and really like connect that with the outer portion of my eyeshadow. And then blend. On the inner corner of the eye, I'm going to go back into that nude matte shadow, and I'm basically going to pop this onto the inner corner. The cool thing is, this isn't too much lighter than my current skin tone. So I can get it everywhere and not really worry too much about it. The eyes are gonna look a little bit crazy and unbalanced for a bit because I am gonna work on the rest of my face because again, I'm a terrible, terrible wannabe beauty guru. I'm gonna take my Physicians Formula Butter Bronzer just on a big fluffy brush. Under the chin, of course. I'm gonna jump into the Shade and Light palette from Kat Von D, and I'm also coincidentally using the Kat Von D Shade and Light palette brush doodad. I really like this color because it's still on the warm side, but it's a bit deeper than my butter bronzer. I use the most minuscule amount, like it's not even a thing. I really only contour like this when I do a really, really heavy eye look, just because I feel like the face kind of needs it to be balanced. I really only focus that under the cheekbones too. I don't like to take it up onto the forehead or anything. I'm just blending out what I already had. Since I have a double chin though, I will take some under here too, just to sharpen that up. I'm gonna go ahead and do my blush. Today I'm using this one from MAC. It's called Stunner. It's just a pale pinky color. Any pale pink blush with shimmer will do. My go-to blush brush is the It Cosmetics boutique brush. I love It Cosmetics. Their brushes are the bay. I will just say that lately I've been taking a little bit of cream along with a little bit of yellow and just go right under the eyes with this mixture. Why are you focusing that hard, camera? And I feel like this mixture kind of helps prevent flashback from the translucent powder. And also just brightens a little bit more on the under eye, which is nice. I nearly forgot to contour my nose. For that, I just use the butter bronzer. I don't like the really dark contour for this particular step. And I'll just basically take this little It Cosmetics brush and go down the sides of my nose. I'm not super precise because it never quite turns out for me when I try to get like a specific shape or anything like that with my nose contour. It's really just more so that it looks more balanced with the rest of my face, because I just never think it looks right. For my brows, I'm just doing my normal brow routine. I'm gonna kind of blaze through this because, I don't know, just feel like no one cares what I'm doing with them. They're a little bit too light for how dark my roots are right now, but that's okay. I would rather just keep my usual brow products than buy them in darker shades when my roots are dark like this. Although honestly, my roots are dark 99% of the time, so I don't know why I don't just do that. I'm gonna take the Anastasia Brow Definer in Taupe, and I'm gonna make a line under my brow, brush it out, then brush down the hairs on top, and do the same thing. I'm just literally outlining the brow, and I'm gonna show you like the difference after and, you know, before and after is the proper term there. Basically, once that looks semi-presentable, I'm then going to go in using the Brow Wiz from Anastasia. Same color, just in taupe. And I'm really gonna define areas like this inner corner of my brow. Make small little hair-like strokes. My brows are super messy right now, by the way. So just don't pay any attention to that. Then I brush them out again, and that's literally it. I just set them with a bit of clear brow gel once my makeup is all complete. So I'm gonna highlight, and there are two steps to this process, at least for me. Take something more natural, think like Hourglass Mineral Veil, something with like less shimmer. I'm using MAC Mineralize Skin Finish and Light Scapade, and I laugh every time I say it because I use this product so much. I'm gonna highlight all of the high points of the face. You probably know how to do this, but I just like to take this pretty much everywhere I want that glow. Something for me is I never put that highlight on the tip of my nose. I don't like what it does for my nose shape. Instead, I'll really focus it right here in the center. And I feel like it almost like makes that look more straightened out. I don't know if that even makes any sense. I have a little bit of a bump on this side, so that's just what I like to do. I'm gonna take the Hello Light Radiance Pressed Powder in the shade G-Lowy. get it like glowy. This is my collaboration with It Cosmetics and I wanted to use it in a few videos. It's super limited edition, super limited stock. That's why I never really made a video because once it's gone, it's gone. And while it was so fun to create, like I didn't want to put a big fuss behind it and then, you know, have people get really upset when it was no longer in stock, but I will have it linked down below. So I'm gonna take this and just pop it right on the high points of the face. It's a little bit more pink. Normally I would say I gravitate towards something that's more of like a white gold, but also I feel like everyone has already done that. I wanted to create something that was like the palest, softest rose gold ever. And I love how it reflects the light, but I like just putting it on the really high points of the face. Today I'm feeling a little bit daring, so I think I may actually pop it right there at the inner corners of the cheeks. Also, take it pretty much everywhere else I already highlighted. We're getting close to lips, so I'm just moisturizing using chapstick. I mean, I'm moisturizing using my Dior lip balm. It's $30. I actually had that lip balm and I really loved it, but I also really love my chapstick. And then going to line my eyes using a little bit of Collection Noir liquid black liner from NYX. So while I wait for that to dry, I also just like to set off my face using Urban Decay All Nighter Makeup Setting Spray. Basically taking a bath in it today because I have a lot of powder. Applied a bit of really dark brown liner to my waterline and upper tight line just because I hate doing it on camera. I don't know, it grosses me out to watch, so I never wanna like inflict that pain on anyone else. The reason that I use dark brown for this particular look, it's a little bit softer and I feel like it adds sort of like a gradient to the eyes. Like the inner portion is still dark brown. It's not super black, it's not super harsh, and then it's gonna like transition into black as it goes out. You know. I forgot to highlight my inner corner of my eye, so I'm gonna really quickly do that. Again, just using Glowy, oh, I love saying that so much, by It Cosmetics, because she is a gem. Now on curled eyelashes, I'm going to apply mascara. Lately, I'm using the CoverGirl Clump Crusher. Is that what this is? No, it's Lash Blast. Where did I get that from? I think there's a version of this called Clump Crusher, but that is not what this one is. I just love how like nice and dark this makes the lashes and it separates them so beautifully. I don't know, this is one of those mascaras where I just really like it with falsies. Even though, I mean, that probably sounds silly because it's like when you wear falsies, it's not even like you notice your real lashes, but I like how it makes everything blend, you know? For lashes today, I'm gonna be using the Vegas Nay for Allure Bronzed Beauty, or Bronze Beauty, rather. They're not mink, obviously, because they're like $12 at the drugstore, but they're supposed to look like mink, and I think they actually really do accomplish that. They're like really, really thick and flirty and beautiful, and I'm excited. I've been waiting for my glue to dry for like 10 years, but now I can just pop this bad boy right on there. Maybe it's just me, but I always feel like glue takes a little bit longer to dry on like a fresh eyelash, like a fresh band, and it never quite sits right the first round. I usually have to re-glue things, like the inner corner isn't gonna stay down this first time, I'm sure. I always hate breaking in lashes. I like them like the second, third, fourth wear. Just because I always really do like to show the before and the after. You can see how these just really accentuate that cat eye shape. They're really like nice and long and fluffy. They actually really don't look that fake in my opinion, which is really nice. I'm gonna set off my brows using some clear brow gel. I also did pop mascara on the lower lashes. And lately I'm back to using my Anastasia brow gel. And I really, really like this. Especially my brows are a bit thicker. I just feel like it really, really keeps things in place. Today I'm gonna be trying out these new Makeup Revolution matte lip kits. This one is in the shade Rain. I'm gonna be using the lip liner first. By the way, these are like $10 at Ulta. Oh, do you see how bright that is? That is not gonna work out. Okay, so I am just gonna jump back into the Kylie lip kit. Actually, I'm using two different products. This is the Dolce K lip liner. Then I'm gonna follow up with Candy K liquid lipstick. I had to switch back to my original like kit lens with this camera for this shot. Let me know what you guys think of the new lens down below. I think it's kind of a pain that I can't like zoom in and out for specific shots, but I'm excited to know what you guys think. So definitely let me know down below. Let me know how you like this look. Let me know if you try out this look, blah, blah, blah. I'll catch you guys in the next one. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already. Join the family. We would love to have you. And I will catch you tomorrow, actually. Bye.